Hi, welcome to Rides with Chuck. I just had an opportunity to talk with Paul Ritchie, president of Porsche Motorsports North America. He talked about the Porsche GT3 R Hybrid, possibly the most important sports car of this decade.
Well, you want to finish till wait till they finish cleaning it, or?
Oh no, that makes it real.
Come straight off after you.
What have we got here?
Okay, I'm Paul Ritchie from Porsche Motorsport, based in California. Today we're looking at the GT3 R Hybrid, which is a car coming over from Germany. This is a hybrid platform that's been developed in motorsports in Germany, in Weissach. This is hopefully our future in developing a car on the racetrack to develop systems for road usage. So that's the whole idea behind this. This is a test platform. This is not to go flat out win races, but this is to develop hybrid technology, potentially for racing and certainly for road usage in the future. So far, the car has run in the VLN races in Nürburgring. It's run three short races and then, of course, the 24-hour race. And the 24-hour race was very successful, in our opinion, although the car didn't quite complete. It did over 22 hours and really showed the technology at its best. The car led for 8 hours of the race. Phenomenal performance, we believe, and showed the technology. The hybrid system worked perfectly. Unfortunately, it was a different part of the car that let us down during the race. But to succeed 22 hours with a brand new platform like this car, we're very, very excited about it.
Okay,
the basis for this car is the GT3 R, which is being run in Europe at the moment. It's got a 4-liter flat six motor running 480 horsepower. And that's our standard engine in FIA GT at the moment. And then if we go to the front, this is where the hybrid technology comes in. You've got a new front axle with new suspension with two electric motors running across the front axle, running through a gear ratio, get the ratio down to the front wheel. So these motors either act as generators or as electric motors. So when the car's in braking mode, the generators power the flywheel, which stores the kinetic energy until it needs to be released by the driver. You press the button and then that releases the energy back into the front motor, so it goes one way or the other and releases up to 160 horsepower for about 7 seconds on the front axle.
Let me know when you're all done.
The tank on the right, is that the flywheel?
Yes, this is the flywheel.
And to the right, that's one of the converters.
Okay.
And then you've got the boost knob here.
That's the one you press and it releases the flywheel?
Exactly. Flywheel runs up to 40,000 revs. Don't know if I'd want to be sitting next to it.
Well, the big thing about this car is, for the racing side, is we're looking at efficiency in economy and pit stops. We're looking to do less pit stops, we're looking to get more miles per gallon, which means potentially winning races. This car proved that you can use the electric power in some of its modes to substitute the gasoline engine, which saves in an economy. And also you've got the extra squirt of power for up to 7 seconds, 160 horsepower, which gives you a four-wheel drive mode, which really gets you out of the corners and changes the whole dynamic of the car. So. The bottom line is it's a technology that's been used not just for the racetrack, but it's extremely useful, as we've seen in Nürburgring, to develop this on the racetrack.
Fantastic. Thanks for talking.
Yeah, no
that's
problem. Yeah, okay.
Ford, GM, Chrysler, aren't you supposed to be doing this?